Hi folks, my name is Bill Cook. One of the things to realize as real estate investors, as the deal structuring techniques we were using 5-6 weeks ago may not be the best deal structuring tools to use over the next 3 to 6 months. So what are some of the structures that Kim and I think will be working well moving forward? 72 deals, straight options, master leasing, getting owner financing when you buy a property, leasing out a property, but getting an option to be able to purchase it at some point in the future. Buying notes from private money lenders who are holding paper right now, they'd rather have cash. Because truly, creative deal structuring is its own language, and it takes a decade or more to really master the language. So creative deal structuring is its own language. So what we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna go over 5 offers I've put together over the last 5 days. And as I give you what the seller's position is, or the buyer's in some cases, the buyer's position is, I want you to stop the tape and I want you to sit back and ask yourself, how would you structure this deal? What tools would you use to make this happen? So let's go to the offer I made about 2 days ago. I was over at my friend Jody's house. He's my computer guy. He had asked me, he says, when you come over, there's a house 2 houses away from me that's for sale. I'm interested in it. Would you mind taking a look at it with me? I said, sure. And what he really wanted was to watch me walk around the house and look at it and just have me talk out loud, just trying to learn what it is that's going through my head when I'm looking at the house. Well, needless to say, that wasn't enough. We had to put together a written offer. The seller, his mom had passed away, I think back in November. And he had this house and he had it up for sale. He did not want to work with realtors. So there's a FSBO sign in the yard. The thing is, the FSBO sign is way off the street and it's kind of up a hill, so it's really hard to see it. You kind of got to know that it's there. And right now, when someone wants to see it, because he lives in Atlanta, he has a neighbor come over and show it, or one of his friends come over and show it, and they're kind of getting tired of showing it and him not taking any offers. So his asking price is $145,000 on this home. That's a fair price. That's right at fair market value on this home. So how would you structure this deal? What would you use? What tools would you use? Okay, so this is the offer I put together. I put together something called a teeter-totter offer. And the reason why is I've not sat down with a seller yet face-to-face. When I sit down and talk to someone, usually I'm gonna develop it into one offer put together based on what it is they're wanting done. But in this case, all I had was voicemail. So I couldn't talk to him about what he wanted. So I had to make the best of it. So I used a teeter-totter offer. So another word for that is a price terms offer. So think of a teeter-totter, price terms. And in this case, if he wanted $145,000, my answer was, yeah, in fact, I'll pay you $150,000. Why would you pay someone more than the asking price? Because you're gonna give them price, but what you get is how do you pay the $150? That's terms. So this is how I make so many owner-financed offers, is I just put together a teeter-totter offer. So I'll let him pick the price as long as I get to say how we're going to pay him. Or if he sits back and says he wants all cash, so now what he's asking for is terms, how he's gonna get paid. I'll give him all cash, but I get to name the price, and that's probably gonna be somewhere about $100,000 for that home. Because it was his mom's house, it needs a good bit of updating, there's a good rehab to do there, but great house, great neighborhood, great location. So the offer I put together was, we'd be happy to pay him the $145,000 price. I would give him $10,000 down, and then make monthly payments to him of $650 a month until that mortgage was paid. And I also made him a cash offer, which was $100,000. If he said yes to the deal, Jody buys the property, not me. The reason why is Jody is on W-2 income, and so is his wife. And by owning the rental property, they'll gather the tax benefits. The way the closing will work is the owner of the property will give Jody a warranty deed, so he owns the property, he and his wife, and Jody's gonna give the owner a note and then a deed of trust, also known as a mortgage in some states, but a deed of trust, and that just secures the promise of payments to the property. So the property's the collateral for the loan. So if Jody doesn't make the payments, the lender can foreclose, get the property back. That kind of leaves me out in the cold. So let's see how I work myself in. At closing, I want Jody is gonna give me a 30-year option to buy that property at any time in the 30 years, for the whatever the balance of the mortgage is then. So in other words, every month that Jody makes a mortgage payment, that purchase price goes down a little bit. My purchase price goes down a little bit. And then with each month that passes, as the property increases in value, do you see where I'm creating equity as time goes by? So my purchase price doesn't have to be a number. It can just say, for whatever the balance is on the mortgage, whenever I, when and if I exercise my option to do that. Also a part of the option agreement, and I may do this, yeah, it'll be in the option agreement. Jody's gonna agree that as the monthly payments come in, because there's gonna be about $400 a month in cash flow after all expenses are paid. So Jody's gonna get 2/3, and I'm gonna get 1/3 of the rent. So we're gonna split the rents. Remember, Jody owns it, he's getting the cash benefits, but he's also taking care of the property. And then finally, what if I do exercise the option, and then one day I do sell the property, whatever we get from it, we'll split the profits 50-50. So my purchase price will be the balance of the mortgage. Then if I turn around and sell it, whatever we make, we split that 50-50. So do you see where that's a really good deal for Jody and where that's a really good deal for me? And it's also a good deal for the homeowner because he's going to be getting monthly payments in, and I don't know that he wants a big chunk of cash. It may be the monthly payments are what he's looking for.
To watch the rest of the four creative deals, click on the playlist on the screen now. And for additional education, check out the links below. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more great real estate content.